Okay, I had someone ask about installing new speakers on a first gen Tacoma. So they are pretty trash, so I went out and bought some Infinity 86 CFX speakers. Put in the front doors, and since I have an extended cab, I'm not even going to bother with the rear speakers because they don't help at all, really. So I'm only going to be doing nicer speakers up in the front. So I didn't care about the rear ones, so I took any budget I would have for rear speakers and applied it to some really nice door speakers for the front. So I'm going to take off this door card and start removing this speaker and this tweeter. So there's a screw here. I've never taken this off before, so gotta learn. Two screws in here. That's it. Let's go around. There we go. Broke apart. Yeah, I figured. I'm gonna have to go get new clips. They're breaking apart. I don't think this door has ever been taken off. Forward. Ah, got it. There's a bee over here and it's entertaining itself. Come on. So now that green thing needs to come undone so I can take this handle off. Okay, to get this little green thing out, I just pulled it off this bottom part, I just pulled it off like that. So you just pull it over, it pops off the wire. Unplug the tweeter. Looks like I only broke three clips, but here's our tweeter. Here's our stock speaker. So, tweeter wires are here. I'm not gonna be using tweeter. These have a coaxial setup. And then here's the stock speaker. So, here, I'll zoom out a little bit. Yeah. Pretty junk. Foam already started coming off. So here's our wires right here. Now I'll just install these if you're going to be installing these without replacing the head unit or anything like wires, like an amp. Eventually I'm going to put an amp in here. So you can see I have this amp that I'll eventually install, but I'm just going to wire these up to my Kenwood head unit. So,
goes
through. Unscrew the speaker. There's your stock Toyota speaker, 4 ohm, 20 watt. I'm gonna have to cut this plastic bracket out because it hits my magnet. So, yeah. I get like a Dremel. That out so you can see what I need to cut out, and hopefully I don't hit this window guide for the window, or I might have to space this out some more. So looks like I need to cut the door a little bit. Shit. These speakers have too big of like a bracing on them. Cut just by a little bit. If your speakers have really big bracing for the voice coil and the magnet, you need to do this to your speaker hole. Cut all that plastic out, cut fingers in the metal, and then bend it over. Now I'm going to have to go fill this in with caulking to seal this against the door frame. So that's what you got to do to fit somewhat decent speakers or big speakers that have some depth and some bracing. So after figuring out how far I needed to cut, I removed the bracket and a little foam, cleaned it up a little bit. So now you can just easily go in there. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws that hold this on. And on this back side, I'll have to seal this. Let's see if I can get focus here. Have to get this to seal around the door. So, okay, I'm gonna seal up this with some silicone. So I'm gonna take some tape, create a barrier. So you can see, I just used some silicone to fill in that. And I have some tape on the back here to create a barrier so it doesn't come out the other side. So, hopefully that sets up. I'll probably smooth it over a little bit, but it'll be good. So, quite a bit later, I have some sound deadening on the door now. You haven't seen that. Speakers in, and I'm just going to button the rest of it up.
So I'm starting the amplifier install for the Tacoma. So I'm on the driver's side, and there's a grommet right here. This is my CB wire. This is my 4-gauge New Concepts power wire. So I have a fuse box as well. So this wire will run into this terminal. And then I'll probably have the fuse box on top of this one or on the side of it, somewhere where it looks clean. I'd rather not do the top. And that one, I want to say it's 100 amp fuse in it. It's install gear. I'll have the links to all this stuff that I use for this install in the video. But there's our grommet there. I just scored a little plus with a knife and pushed it through. And then on the other side, come around this way. That comes in through up there. Then what I'll do is I'll run it underneath this panel down here, around here through the carpet, and I'm going to have the amplifier behind the driver's seat right there. So I have my power in, ground, remote, and then front left, front right. So that is how I'm going for the amp install in my 2004 Tacoma. You can see I already have the speaker install going on over there. The whole inside of the door is sound deadened, and I have patches around that second skin of it, this second skin of the door. So I took out this little door sill. You unscrew it and you pop it up, and then this slides out. This little kick panel here slides out, so pull towards you. That'll come out, and I'm just gonna run my line down this way. Keep following through this way, underneath the carpet. Come up from underneath the carpet. I'm gonna cut a little section out, have the wire pop up through into the power. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut a little cross right here and right here. Or I might just do one, because I might be able to ground, I don't know, at the ground somewhere where there's a good body connection. But I'm gonna go ahead and cut that little cross right here in the carpet so I can run my power cable right into my power inlet. Okay, so I now have my power wire ran through, and I'm ready to terminate it and connect it up. Okay, so I got everything wired back there. Now I'm running up to my fuse block. This is an install gear fuse block. I think it's 120 amp. I can't remember. It's something like that. But it comes like with these little shims for 4-gauge wire. So I'm going to cut this wire. So I'll take this shim and I'll cut the wire right there, put it in, and then tighten it down inside the fuse block. Okay, now that's all done. Both sides are in there. I'm actually gonna cover the bottom of this block with 3M VHB. And I don't want to screw holes into my stuff, like my fuse cover. So I'm just going to put this on the bottom of it and stick it on. I don't think it will really ever come off unless you rip the whole thing off. It's pretty strong, so I trust it. Okay, so I have my negative hooked up. Have it going right into the body here. I made sure I cleaned up all the metal, the threads on the bolt, the bracket, the washer. So that's all clean metal going straight to the frame. And then there's all that. So now I gotta pull out the head unit and run RCAs into the input, and then run speaker wires, and then finally connect it to the battery power. Okay, so continuing from yesterday, I have my center console, whatever, entertainment area. Pulled out. I ran RCAs, which are right here, to the RCA out on the back of my Kenwood. And then I have a signal wire, which goes up underneath here, down this way. Signal wire goes under here, and then it goes right in there, the middle wire. So that's my signal wire for the amp. On the Kenwood, it's a blue wire with a white stripe. And what that wire does is it signals this amplifier to turn on when the vehicle's on. So that wire sends a low voltage signal to this terminal and tells the amp, hey, power on. So that's done. Now all I have to do is run the RCAs, which I think I'm gonna try and run down the center of the truck right here, so I can go right into the back side of the amp. And then I just have to run speaker wires. So I'm gonna try and keep my speaker wire as far away from my main power wire. So, like at least an inch of separation. And if you do have to run your power wire over your speaker wire, make sure you have them cross and don't go parallel. So have them go, you know, one go this way, one go that way. So that's where I'm at right now. So now I'm gonna try and run these down through my center console area and shoot straight down to the amplifier. Okay, so I'm removing these new concepts RCAs. They're just way too long. I'm replacing them with this media bridge RCA that I have that's just about the right length. So taking out the new concepts, putting in the media bridge. Okay, back to square one. These connectors are way too long. They hit the AC vents in the back. Okay, so I got the RCA ran all the way down to the amp. So I have my one speaker wire running from there, under here, front right channel, negative, positive, and then that runs down this center, under here, through here, up under here, through here, through this grommet, out to here, and then into the speaker. Okay, I got that all done. I got some bigger head screws in here because the ones that were in it are too small and they're sucking through the holes. So I got some bigger ones. I pulled the excess wire out through the back here, so I don't have just loose wire dangling around in there. And now I guess I'll finish up the amp and see and make sure it actually works, power it on. So finishing up my amp install, I cut my positive wire, ran it to the terminal. So it's all ready to go. I can power it up and test the speakers. So, looks good. Let's go see if it powers on. Okay, truck's on. Power light's on. Got audio out of that speaker. Seems to be working well. Okay, so door panel's back on. Everything's buttoned up over there. Put a few more pieces of a sound deadener, just some small pieces. I didn't know if I should cover up that hole in the door skin, that second skin, the inside skin, or not. I just left it open. I was like, whatever, it's fine. I'm not too worried about if there's any improvements to mid bass or anything like that. So I got the fader, that one there. So this left one is still stock, and I don't know how well this microphone's gonna pick up the differences, but I'll play. Keep a close eye on the things trying to harm me, warn me if anybody try to swarm me. Invest in a rock and a rock pile up, hella stacks when the bills pile up, dollar. It's the only way to get the style up, riled up, cause you motherfuckers use the dial up.
My dog is gone, and the result is to hide my Teflon. Christian Dior and the fashion beyond. Talking Polo, call me Polo the Dawn. Throw some D's on the tone. I got hella keys in a phone. I put hella G's in a vote. It took only three to assault. Damn, Jesus, please deliver us from evil. Please pray over all my people. What you see in life seems evil. I don't wanna lose my desert evil. Big talk, speedboat. Pray to God I don't get repo. Didn't go to college for a free throw. People getting killed through the peephole. Pay your money up before you go to war.
Okay. For certain that'll be copyrighted, but whatever. I don't really intend to make money off of YouTube views. So that's what it sounds like. Okay, got the driver's side door done. I have it on the inside and on the second inside skin. So now have seems pretty good to me. Okay, so the doors are done, each side. So I still have the OEM, OE speakers in the back, which I'll probably just make sure they're not on. So now, this is all done. I move heaven and earth with two fingers, paralyzing weak niggas with these killer bee stingers. We don't hear that weak shit that you bring up, popping your lips, bowling my fist, making sure you sip the food that you heat up. You ain't know that your cheek was an eater, popping the guard in the crib, rolling shooters while I'm kicking my feet up. Hey. The best you never heard, bars hitting like you stomped on the curb. Fuck out of here. I done heard you spit your best 16. I'm damn hot, so you gon' get sketched from a flame. No horse shit, I'm wet from the rain. When the temperature rise, your identity get left in the flames. Cause you could get left in the train. Cause when it come to grind that I bump it out like Fresh, not his name. I used to be impressed by you lame. Now when you see the Mac shells fly out like jets in Ukraine, be mad like you try to throw a hex on my name. I play with y'all, but no, I'm not a game. So much you can say. You remain my power, my pleasure, my pain, baby. To me, I'm like a grown addiction that I can't shake out. Won't you tell me is a healthy baby? But did you know that when it snows, my eyes become a light, and the light that you shine can't be seen.
Say you. kick it?
Yes, we can.
Can I 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 kick it?
Yes, we can.
I'm gone.
Can I kick it to all the people who can quest like a tribe does? Before this, did you really know what I was? Comprehend to the track force, why? Cause getting mentions on the tip of the vibe buzz. Rock and roll to the beat of the funk.
Okay, so I went through quite a few different songs there to give somewhat of an example of how they sound. They have a lot of mid-bass, and it's punchy, not very muddy mid-bass. If I maybe sealed the maintenance holes in the doors, it might sound a little bit better.
I'm not that too worried about it. I mean, it's just a truck that gets used for what a truck should be used for. It's not like any kind of audio build or anything like that. So, yeah, it's not too bad. I don't think I'll ever add a sub. There's no not much room back here for a sub without taking up any of the space where I could put stuff. So I think I'm just going to keep it to these two front door speakers and just have the fader lose the two rear OE speakers, because they're pretty much pointless back there. No one really sits back there, and I'd rather have two good speakers up front. So I need to also tune the amp for this head unit. I don't remember what I have it at, but I'll have to get a multimeter out and then tune the amp with some pink noise or whatever and set the voltage right. But sounds good, way better than it sounded before. Before I had like muddy bass that was just terrible and the vocals were bad. So that's it. I gotta put all this stuff back in through here. The amp is right there. You can see the blue light. So that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. I'll have links to any of the stuff that I used in this video series in the description if you're curious on what to get or what to buy. This is kind of a thing where you just kind of go on your own and build it how it's necessary, so it's probably not smart to buy some of the stuff I did unless it's like speakers or the amp or some wire. But like I said, it kind of all depends on how you're going about your build, depending on what you buy and what you use. So thanks for watching. See you later.